Today we're munching on Korean barbecue, and boy oh boy, sizzle alert!
안녕 친구!
안녕 친구!
It is rainy and windy. We saw umbrellas rolling on the ground like tumbleweed. We are at Insadong and about to get dinner.
Oh, it looks like we go inside here. They serve rice and bamboo.
안녕하세요. 오, 새가 있네. 안녕하세요. 안녕하세요.
For seating on the left, take your shoes off and sit on the elevated platform. The tables on the right are Western style. Keep shoes on and sit on a chair. All tables have a grill. In the corner is a selfie of Mother Nature.
It's almost 5:20 p.m. on a Tuesday. We are getting the Cha Iyagi meal set. That's a 15,000 won per person.
Fresh leaves always accompany Korean barbecue. Here we have shredded cabbage with black sesame dressing, broccoli, and wait a second, is that samjang? Whoa, it's my first time seeing samjang mixed with nuts. Anything with nuts is two thumbs up by default. Napa cabbage kimchi, onion, tubu, seasoned squid.
After we lift this open, we have to take out the charcoal. Do not eat it. Inside this kettle, we have corn tea. After we finish the rice in this, we'll pour that in here. Mamyo, check out this detail. They indented a little bit just for the can opener. After you take out the charcoal, we have to mix the rice and all the other ingredients.
The rice is topped off with jujube, ginkgo, and beans. Time to mix it up like a bibimbap.
It's a little bit of a workout to mix the rice. Smells really nice. It smells a little woody. After all, it is in the bamboo.
Oh, can't stop smelling it.
You know, when you go to the Korean spa and you're in the hot rooms, it smells like that. The room with a lot of wood. What meat do we order?
No biryani, lightly marinated.
That's pretty good. The marinade is a little bit on the sweet side, but not overly sweet where you're like, oh, this is candy. Slightly savory. Well, let's try a little bit of the doenjangguk. Mamyo says it's pretty spicy. In this bite, we have some mushroom and tubu. Oh dang, it's spicy. Oh dang. Whoa. Wow, it's getting to my ears. Woohoo. Doenjangguk is not always this spicy. But here we have plenty of pepper.
My first time trying Nutty Ssamjang. Is this amount just enough or am I being too confident? I'm sensitive to spicy food, so let's keep it humble.
The texture is like steamed peanut or even like soaked raw almonds, but cut into bits, it has that sort of texture. Let's try some of this salad. Well, actually, when you pull it up, they're very short. Quite sweet. I wouldn't be surprised if you put like a little bit of apple juice in that.
Mamyo prepares a ginyip sum, perilla leaf wrap.
Two thumbs up or three thumbs up? Two. Is there invisible thumbs up?
Very good.
I like perilla. Right. Whatever with perilla leaves, it's two thumbs up.
What about wrapping grilled perilla leaves in perilla leaves? Would that be four thumbs up?
Yes.
Two thumbs squared. I'm pretty excited to try this tubu. There's some sesame seed in that. If you never had tofu before, it tastes plain and it tends to be soft. Tofu comes in varying textures. It could be silky and smooth and very slippery and breaks apart easily, or you could have like a more firm one. And this one is on the firm side. And the tofu in the doenjangguk, it's also on the firm side. If it's a very soft tofu and you try to pull it up, it'll just break apart, slip right through.
Next up is seasoned squid.
It's not cooked to squid. It's raw squid, marinated with garlic, hot pepper paste.
Very sweet. And it looks very spicy because it's like fully red. The texture is... Okay, the spicy is kicking in. the texture, it's very smooth. It's almost smooth like Michael Jackson's moonwalk. There's like scallion in that. Oh, here's a bigger piece. Super smooth. You know, the texture is like mung bean jelly, but maybe even softer than that. But not quite as soft as the sundubu.
Wait, the samjang has sunflower seeds. I've never seen
this kind of samjang.
I like it. And I'm gonna put a little bit of veggies in there as well.
We have raw garlic in this container.
It might make you cry.
It has made me cry a couple times. I'm gonna get the thinnest one. Place it on that. Oh, I didn't try the kimchi yet.
I like that kimchi. Some restaurants when you go to in Korea, the kimchi will make you cry because it's such a tragedy. It doesn't taste good. But this kimchi, oh, it's gonna make you cry in a happy way. It's missing something. Kimchi. That raw garlic is attacking me right now.
Let's make some with a curly kale. Look at how gorgeously ruffled this leaf is.
Normally, I'm not a big fan of samjang, and I'm a little bit shy to put too much. But this one, this samjang is, it has nuts in it. It's a very unique samjang. Normally, I don't just take a leaf and put samjang on it, but this one has so much substance. You can't just have the leaf with that.
We finished the meat. Now we shall grill the garlic and tame that spice.
Oh, I see what you're doing. You're putting the garlic on the hole.
Yeah. Smells like vampire extermination.
I normally don't like raw onions, but I'll give it a go. Mmm, tastier than I thought. It's very likable.
Mommy put squid on tofu and she's grilling it.
We're cooling down the grilled tofu with a swaying leaf. Towards the end of dinner, I realize the ceiling is in the style of traditional Korean architecture. At the entrance, they grow tomatoes. Up next, we visit a hidden tea house inside a hanok, a traditional Korean home. The owner's family actually used to live in it. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. For food and travel outside of Korea, check out my other channel, Miss Mina. Catch you next week. 안녕!
I have been disappointed by kimchi in Korean restaurants in Seoul so many times. Typically, cheaper restaurants don't serve the best kimchi. They might skimp out on some ingredients, but this one, we're gonna finish this kimchi before we leave.
Our set meal options include 떡갈비, 갈비살, and 쌈밥. When dining in Korea, businesses label where the ingredients come from. These meats are from the US. This set meal contains meat from both US and Korea.